Hello everyone, welcome to the final episode of the AMD Streamer Challenge, where we played the likes of Fall Guys, Valorant, and Dota throughout the season. We started in September, and Asarai has been here with me on this journey. How are you doing today?
I am doing fantastic, my friend. And like you said, it has been a long journey, but we have finally arrived to this point. Yeah,
it's taken a while, but we've gotten here. We saw a bunch of different games that were going on. I mean, we saw the fan interactions, being able to play with the fans and the streamers and all that stuff, which has been really great. And we saw just how competitive some of these guys actually are, and they were willing like to go all out just to win those prizes. So let's go into the first section, which is going to be the Southeast Asia region, and we're going to take a look at some of the highlights that we had. But it's going to be our HP-powered streamers who were played on the HP Pavilion Gaming 15 laptop while rocking EPOS audio headsets. Representing Singapore was UU Monster, Malaysia was Lejo Set, Thailand was represented by Will Come Back, and Larissa Rockfort was from Indonesia. Now in episode 2 was our Fall Guys challenge. Our streamers had to race against the clock to see who could win the most crowns. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from this challenge. We'll be right back with the highlights, but before we do, I guess we wanted to kind of break down a little bit more. I mean, that was episode 2. We had Fall Guys. That was a bit of a challenge there. That was an interesting one. We've also had, you know, Fnatic playing Dota. We're going to get some of those highlights as well later on today, as well as the Valorant ones, and we've kind of gone on this journey again and seen all of these things, and everybody kind of played it throughout. So any thoughts before we go into those highlights?
I want to see Valorant right now.
We will get everything, patience. We're going to get to it. It's just going to be a matter of time, but we will get into Valorant later. but can they grab the oh, she dies under it. The outplay. What? All right, all right.
Dude, this foam mountain is crazy. Everything's so fast.
All right, now she's just stuck.
No, this is
Oh, she's first.
She's the lead.
She is doing so well. And look at that. She's the dot. Oh.
She's good. She's good.
She could actually still get first.
Oh, but
if
the hammer.
Her opponent doesn't get knocked. Oh, she got pushed back.
All right, all right. Slide forward. Oh, she lost a lot of positioning, but it doesn't really matter. Oh!
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh. Please, no. Not like this.
Oh, that duck saved her, kind of.
The inhumanity.
She's good.
She can reach it. Okay,
all
she's
right,
good.
29. Ooh. All right, so Larissa here. Hopefully, she's managed to get the seesaw. Okay. Nice. Get to the high ground.
She's vibing.
She's got it. Oh!
She's got it.
Oh, no! Oh, she jumped at the same time.
Did she just get blocked?
Wow, that was risky. That 180 turnaround.
No. Oh, no. She's been grabbed.
Okay.
Oh. Oh, no. She got pushed.
Wow.
Oh.
The BM.
Oh, man.
Wow.
So that's the thing. Okay, when somebody's coming at you and looking to grab you, if you grab them back, it nullifies it. Right?
No.
If you get grabbed. Oh, she's gotta be careful of that seesaw. That was good.
That
was nice. That was nice.
Wow, that
she stopped.
Just like basically unloaded 5-10 people.
No, she saw that it was bad and she was like, I'm not getting on this one.
Oh.
Oh man. Oh, she's been grabbed. Those are the worst. The grabbers. This guy. Damn pigeons. Oh. I have no idea where up is. Oh! No.
Oh, no.
Get on the other.
Oh.
That was the edge. Look at the slime. It's so close.
No. Oh, my God.
All right. Okay. We got it. We're good. No, why did I jump?
Oh, no.
Jump.
No, grab it.
Use your grab.
Not like this. She got it.
Oh,
wait for it.
Oh, she's good.
Nice.
She's good. Oh, on the edge. Okay.
Even she can't believe it. Oh, wow. This is it.
Oh, this is... I mean, 7 qualify, right?
Oh, go.
Oh, she fell off. No.
Oh, man. She's getting...
Over. All right.
Second try.
Oh, no.
Okay, at least you did it.
No, the slime. 38.
There's one more. Last slot.
Go.
Last slot.
Go.
No.
No.
39. 39 jumps.
Yo, that slime is actually rising real fast.
Yeah, I think he really needs
to.
She cannot make any more mistakes. This is it.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Yeah.
She's got it.
Oh. That was scary. Did you see the pirate, like, looking at her?
Yeah.
Oh!
Wow!
Look at
she
fancy
is dancing!
Footwork.
Yeah, she's
Dang.
Dancing!
Oh my goodness, that was...
That was hilarious.
Was it supposed to call highlights or like fun lights? Because those were pretty hilarious too.
Fall Guys, it's kind of hard to get highlights, let's be honest. I think there were low lights, if anything. There were humorous moments for sure.
Yeah, all right. So next, we pitted our HP streamers against each other for some heated Valorant action. First up was a round robin. Rankings would determine the prizes fans won, and then we had special show matches, each with their own unique rules. First was Malaysia versus Singapore, which was protected VIP mode, where the first streamer to die 5 times lost the match. Then we had the Indonesia versus Thailand in Spike Expert, where the first streamer to get 8 plants or defuses would win the game. So let's take a look at the highlights for this Valorant action.
Except Malaysia just having a good
left.
Couple rounds. Does seem like for this time we would try to even the score. Oh, a triple kill! Yeah, Singapore just trying to hold those unorthodox spots. But dopamine here, you mentioned about the judge. Oh, he actually caught 3 of them, but they were just too far for the judge to be effective. That being said, it did do quite a bit of a decent damage on the couple of some of the members. The classic will get pulled out. Sagara's gonna be the first one to go down. And will that do the trick? Lemon Tea is going to get the spray down with the Ares. Swarm Grenade going to come up. Does it catch the Cypher though?
One enemy remaining.
He's definitely holding down the defuse button, but it does seem like gun. And yes. It's gonna reveal where the Reyna is. Trying to go for that one tap. And wow, Sushi Boy. Well, that does give Team Thailand a little bit of hope. Or rather, Team Indonesia a bit of hope. Reyna. Gonna try to once again get the entry. Frag will open the account against Jet.
Wait, they have to try to go for the defuse.
What is? Hello?
Wait, what?
Team Malaysia? Josette?
That is...
Wait, do they know this is match point? Wait.
Do they know that they're on the defending side, though?
Oh, hello?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, no, GG. Oh,
come on.
GG.
Oh.
Attackers.
He knows there's something pushing in. Team Malaysia, what are they doing? They're going for the side. That's going to be shot. Oh, the spike actually does drop right in front of him. The second shot comes in. He's not going to get the miss down here. And, well... want to get the traits because you can definitely assure that it's going to be a 5v2 or at most a 5v3 when you enter the site. And you're going to see Sushi Boys, no mistake there, double frag onto Heavens, and it's going to be a triple frag. It is a 4-kill round for him, almost going to use the teleport, but they don't even need it.
Going to be a nice little head tappy taps as the defenders are coming in with the fury here. You two, oh, he's just connecting the shots, the tappy taps, and the
fury is going to immediately get taken out. By the operator, oh, Sushi Boy gonna check the right and left as always when crossing the road.
Definitely gonna be to the side of Welcome Back. They don't really have to challenge these, but Sushi Boy will. It's a nice little head tappy there onto Frozen Steam.
Not too sure if he's holding the Bucky. I wouldn't recommend Bucky for attacking air, but Sagara with the backstab, you mentioned about it. The recon bot's gonna come out, but not sure. Oh, he didn't even need the recon bot. The Vandal's coming in, so he kind of baited Mouski there with the recon bot, but. It's gonna alert the rest of Team Indonesia as to where the remaining survivor is. Doesn't matter though, Sagara's gonna get taken down immediately.
Spike the better because he does have his Hunter's Fury, so he can use this to either cancel his opponent's ultimate.
Malaysia's and Sagara pushes right through the smoke, the double kill, the spray down onto the corner. Once again, oh, the recoil ball comes in, but it gets enough time for Sagara, and it's gonna be a quad kill.
Why do I keep saying tappy taps?
Like just... Head tap, you gotta make sure, because you're making sure you're clicking heads and you're being very clear of what happened. There were some tappy taps going on.
But that was some really good highlights. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. And now we're gonna go for a quick break. And of course, that's gonna be a word from our sponsors. So guys, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
And we're back to the AMD Streamer Challenge. This is the final one. We just saw some ads. I mean, some of those ads looked amazing in terms of like the EPOS one. That looked like Cyberpunk 2077 as opposed to what I'm playing at home, which is Cyberpunk 2020. I think it looked just terrible. Anyways, but we're going to go into the next set of highlights. It's going to be Southeast Asia Squad. And this is one's powered by Acer. They were playing on the Acer Nitro 5 laptop, getting the highest audio quality with the EPOS headsets. Our Acer streamers were Riku representing the Philippines, Tanix Live from Thailand, and finally Gemma Show representing Indonesia. Our Acer streamers also faced a Fall Guys race for the Crown Challenge, this time playing with fans to help them win prizes. Let's take a look at some of the Fall Guys action.
Just one last person! You got it? Come on, come on, come on. This guy. Oh, 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 oh! Yes! Yes!
Oh,
oh, that's close. Oh, yes. Oh, oh. Tanek sabotaged his whole team. But in the end, they still made it. Blue team has now 1 point. The fan took it away. No, let the fan take it. Let the fan take it. Blocks it. Blocks it. Block it. 4 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. The fan takes it all. But now this is also this is also the one that eliminates a lot of people. He has so much space.
Production, we're gonna end this way too early. Ban him, ban this guy. Stop going to the right side of the seesaw. Come on.
You can still jump on it. It is still okay. You can still jump on it. Oh! Oh!
Run up!
She got it. She got it. She got it.
Yeah, yeets. Yeah, Tanex, he's, or rather Gemma, he's already learned his lesson. He's not YOLOing anymore when the seesaw is way too low. And I think he should. Oh, no, no, no. There's someone in front of him.
Jump. Oh! Come on, come on, come on, Gemma.
He jumped over the whoop boy. Oh, nice. He jumped over the whoop boy. Oh, yes, Gemma. Gemma! Yeah.
go!
Oh,
he can do this! He can do this! He can do this! He just need to cut the other players off! He just need to cut this guy off!
Oh, there's so many guys right now!
Oh no! Oh no!
Oh
no!
Oh yes! Yes! It's gonna be good!
Yes!
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 No!
No!
Yes!
No!
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 No! No! No!
No! The opponent can't win, so it doesn't really matter. Where did that come from? Where did that come from? The second one came from absolutely nowhere. And ladies and gentlemen, it does seem like yellow team is gonna get yoinked out of this game again.
Look at that, just dodging everything as well.
Oh no. Oh wait,
oh, he did.
What?
Wow.
What? What was that?
Masterful.
What?
That was...
Ladies and gentlemen.
What?
Dude.
What? What?
No.
No, 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 no,
no,
no, no,
way.
No, way.
No way.
Well, my goodness, we had an incredible amount of laps there, especially the one with Gemma being thrown out of the... I forgot what map that was, the run.
So close, and they get thrown all the way back, and it's so discouraging that game. It's very frustrating at times.
And he got thrown off by each of the obstacles per platform. Oh my goodness. All right, so that was one of them, guys. Next up was a unique Valorant challenge. Our Acer streamers played against the fans in what was probably the first sponsored Valorant deathmatch event. Finally, our Acer streamers competed with the fans and against each other in the Valorant round robin tournament. So let's check out the Valorant highlights from our Acer streamers.
Nobody was guarding mid.
Oh, and the blind.
Oh,
but he can't hit it. Oh, he can.
Turn it up too. Okay, we talk about pistols.
Okay.
Let's see how good he is with all of these.
Oh!
He's not even reloading. He's a headshot around the corner.
Jesus!
Makabak!
Another one! Makabak! Stop it!
Again, they are struggling to deal with. He's gonna drop this and find one. Pops the head. Perfect.
Or you go with the classic into the light armor. Kind of
depends on the agent. Like if you have a touch though.
Yeah. I mean, this is a nice hot shot there. Oh, but now this is the time where hits him with a through. Rika with the plays. I mean, that shot was pretty sick. Was she swearing?
No, the Omen is still there as well.
Yeah.
Oh, Rika's DC.
But he's running into this. Oh, he teleports away and he teleports behind him. The out.
Yeah, it's no excuse.
Yeah. All right. So, tanks here. Ooh, nice shot. Ooh.
Okay. For them.
Oh, with a nice headshot by tanks. Phoenix up.
The market. Does he get him? And he gets it.
But it's not as long as, like, you know, Valor, CSGO. So there's a still chance for you.
Okay, Gemma. Wall. He hit himself. So I guess that's one way to survive. Or
what? This is perfect. He's going full control. Nice. Gets one.
Nice.
This is beautiful.
Nice.
That's trigger discipline for you. Three bullets in the chamber, though.
Three bullets. Wow. Oh. All right. Here we go. Tanks, let's go. Boom. Boom, boom, boom. I like his, you know.
Oh my god! Somebody stop this guy!
Oh my gosh!
He's doing it!
Exactor for the death sounds.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, death. Yeah.
One of his buddies who's actually good at the game, and no, I'm just kidding, I have no idea. But he's actually turned it up. Maybe the first one round was just a warm-up one, so he's doing actually pretty well here. From Makovan.
And doesn't even have to do much now, because like boss, if you can see the kill feed on the top left, he's been getting he's been getting all the kills now.
Yeah.
I'm awake.
Yeah. Okay.
But just put a little strain on eyes though. So you know, for the viewers out there, you know, you gotta practice good habits, right?
Still get, you know, pre-fired and everything. Gotta be careful.
Oh, she gets a headshot.
And look at my combo, right?
Oh, that's sick.
Nice.
Like, perfect recoil control.
Look at that.
Snap to the head. Like, he's doing everything right at this point.
Oh, he's gonna be the one to hold the the flankers. Kurloss, though, you can see that he is denying them. He hasn't been shut down yet, but there you go. Cracker comes out.
Oh, Riku with the nice
beautiful
play.
Timing on that alert. That is...
Got below. I don't know why.
It happens to the best of us, but yeah. I think it's all about practice.
Yeah. Oh, right around the corner.
Yep. Oh, shot. Oh, sets it general.
He's going to hunt him down. Yeah.
So
that's perfect.
Gonna know. He gets up from the high ground, though. Kraku with the play, beautiful. Though, and he hits it. He's got a B-Haul down. Gets the kill again. Kraku with the play, man.
Breach flashes on the back. This is really, really good. That's why Breach is really strong here.
Oh, the run effect and the teleport. Oh, but he's still Kurloss with the plays. Gets two headshots. He's looking for more, but they did get the spike down. Three. Those are some great highlights, and as a special surprise, we actually have a special guest. We've invited Riku here from the Philippines. She's a representative for Acer, back to the Streamer Challenge, and let's see what she thought about this event. Hi, Riku, how are you?
Hi, I'm happy to be here. Thank you for having me tonight. During the finale, too, it's great.
It's great, and we saw all the highlights. Obviously, you had a lot of fun. There was a lot of emotional moments, so to speak, but is there anything that really stuck out to you?
Oh, where to start? Because there are so many fun things that happened. First of all, the Fall Guys stuff, where you guys could see me either frustrated or very excited towards the last players, especially that one. You guys saw the highlights. For Valorant, I think that's one of the best because I got to fight 10X in Gemma Show in like Indonesia versus Thailand versus Philippines. So it was great representing the region.
Okay, I mean, was there anybody that, like, streamer-wise or fan-wise that you're like, oh, that guy's actually pretty good and I should watch out for him?
Okay, there's a funny recurring thing that me and Gemma would do is that during Deathmatch, I believe, we would hunt for 10X all the time. That's our mission, always kill 10X. And he stood out because he was the one who kept using Viper. So,
was it like a secretive mission? Because I don't think 10X got that memo in the sense that he was being hunted down, right?
We were all in the same chat. We were all in the same Discord. So he knew we were coming for him.
It seems not exactly fair, although 10X Live did quite well, and that says, but okay, you know, was there any of the fans that you really just kind of had that nice little interaction with, or were they like, you know, subscribers of yours, were they, you know, longtime followers of you, and then you were kind of like, it's great to kind of mingle with the peeps, I would say.
I think, I forgot his username because he changed names, but okay. I remember having to join like a PUBG show match back then, and then the recurring story is he would kill me all the time. This happened like 2 years ago. Would always kill me all the time in a battle royale, and now in Valorant, we suddenly are teammates, so it's like, oh, we're not enemies anymore, and you're on my side, so you're the one who's not gonna kill me. It's 10X who's gonna kill me.
So has the relationship lasted longer than just that game? In the sense that, do you continue to play with it? Obviously, you have the friends, you've been partied together. Do you continue to play like that?
Interesting question. I like to play solo, that's the thing.
Okay.
Maybe next time, for sure.
All right, that was a nice way of just rejecting them on the spot.
No! He's on another ELO, okay? So, you know, I don't want to be a burden or anything.
Higher or lower. You don't have to say it. You just point up or down.
I bet he's higher.
All right, Ezra, any questions for Riku?
I guess just one. So, if ever we're going to do another, you know, AMD Streamer Challenge thing, and it's not going to be Valor, it's not going to be Fall Guys, what game would you like to, you know, play with our viewers and with the streamers themselves? You know, I think there's a lot of new ones right here, and anything that might come to mind that you might want to do again for AMD Streamer Challenge?
That's such a difficult question because, like, multiplayer games. I mean, Valorant is still my go-to, definitely, when it comes to competitive FPS. So I can't find any other answer at the moment because, for some reason, Genshin Impact comes to mind, but that's not a competitive game. So back to Valorant. Mm.
Yeah.
I mean,
answer,
yeah, what?
Okay. All right. I mean,
that's it for me. I was just curious.
Okay.
Awesome. Okay. Before we close this one out, do you have anything that you would like to just kind of say to everybody before we kind of close this interview?
Oh, of course. Very, very grateful for the opportunity to be able to showcase my talents in Fall Guys and in Valorant. So big, big thank you to AMD for doing this AMD Streamer Challenge. I got to meet new friends. I got to spent a lot of good memories with Gemma. And I remember calling him Tanks too. So like, I'll go with Tanks. So I spent a lot with those two. And they're really, really fun. And I got to bond with the community too. Because sometimes Gemma's like community would come visit and teach me Indonesian words. So I thought that was pretty fun. I learned Aku Cinta Kamu Semua. I think it's I love you all. Yay, I hope I said it right.
Okay, or it might not be family appropriate, but we're not sure. I don't know. So we'll just continue and we'll pretend like it's all good. Okay.
Nobody translate that. Nobody translate
that. I believe them.
Alright, well thank you so much, Riku, and we will be right back. We're gonna take a little bit of a break and we're gonna be back with more highlights from the rest of the other sessions from the AMD Streamer Challenge. We'll be right back. Now we have to talk about our special guest, Fanatics, who brought out their Pro Dota 2 team for the AMD Streamer Challenge. You know we had to have a couple show matches so some lucky fans had a chance to play with and against their heroes. Let's check out their highlights.
This could be a big fight. They're positioning for the bottom lane here already. Tiny into the front lines, but he's getting demolished from afar. He didn't even have to do anything. Chill will be dropped out by the Crystal Maiden.
The toss in for FaZe's boy. The Chrono catches onto two. They've got something there. The Wisp is on the back end of that. It's going to just lock him into place. And the dagger, the double dagger from DJ and Raven just making short work of him. CM is alive by the False Promise. Raven has gotten like already. He's looking from the surround. He's got the freezing field as well. The finger being pumped. And he hasn't actually used it. And it looks like the Fortune's End locking in Batman. Nowhere to go. And that's going to be the finger popped. And that's four for nothing. Here comes Quancy. They do have the dagger as well. He's within deny range. And he does get denied with Raven with the outplay. Take that damage. He does get away. And the BKB is now going to be committed by Nikita. He's looking to fight this one. He finds Q1 in the next field. And he just slices. But the stream is there, and they do have him, but that's the one with the BKB, and I don't know if that's the one you want to fight. Nikita getting very low, doesn't be careful, and they do get it with the Laguna, so Nikita thought he was strong. Yes, there, he's been glimpsed back, and they're going to look to get to Papa Nikita there and just let him eat this. DJ looking at this fight, and there's Coconut as well, Malediction, Sunstrike, just in case he move forward. P as well, the Ice Wall, he's been slowed down, he has no mana, has been silenced, and Raven. Jessica's so slow, and you I'm sorry that name is too long. I'm going to call her a Witch Doctor. But nonetheless, Witch Doctor. Like, it's very difficult, like, if everybody gets stunlocked. Oh, here comes the Tornado. They do have him. They do have 10 tokens. The Ravage is going to be committed as well as the Deafening Blast. They got the Cataclysm on top and just doing a lot of damage. Death Ward is going to be used, but they're just going to back away here. And Kentos is like, where is everybody? Everybody's dead. Here comes Nikita. Pops the BKB. DJ running for his life. Thinking, man, I should have played Core. But DJ, okay. Nikita, back up, buddy. Back up. Oh, Stormhammer, he wants Pinky. He gets that. The disrespect. They do have two buybacks from DJ. He's like, oh, you went for my buddy? TASV's like, nah, we're gonna go for that. And he gets the Mana Void to explode on him. Nikita goes down. And they do have him. They do spot him. The smoke's been popped and they got the stream, but he pushes him away. The LSA's gonna be a little off the market. Laguna's gonna be used. And he's gonna look to TP away. Nikita, can he get away? He does. Oh, they do have the Deafening Blast as well, but no, Kentos is there. He blinks forward. He does get that. The Death Ward is gonna throw away that TASV from
at all, in any way,
but
shape,
Raven is looking around. He found DJ. You got the gust and the kinetic field is actually going to be a little off the mark as well as the glimpse, but they do have the sunstrike as well, and DJ goes down. Status door is going to be committed, but you don't have the kinetic field, and Blackstream probably just pay for this with his life. He does get streamed back, but it doesn't really matter.
Been awesome. I know that, you know, we're having this event online, nice. But okay, hold on.
Nice three-man Chrono into the Mortimer Kiss. That's actually a nice combination. Does end up killing the Oracle 4F there and Zephyr in addition to Moon. So that's what the combination that they were looking for. That Chrono into the Mortimer Kisses makes it very easy. Are we talking comeback? Like the glimpse is going to just throw DJ back. If anything, that's the one you want. But it looks like the Assassinate is going to connect as well as the LSA. And that's going to be the shield is going to be used, but Deafening Blast as well as the Storm. And can he get away? No, he's dead.
Hey guys, we also had our Fnatic guests flex their gamer muscles. I don't have that, at least Fnatic does, so yeah, that's awesome with them. But having them participate with their fans in a Fall Guys race for the Crown Challenge. So let's take a look at those highlights.
Ninja's like, all right, I've never made it this far. I don't know what to do.
Help each other, but it's very difficult to help in this game.
I think for the first
first few phases, yeah. You have to go in together. And maybe when
jumping, that's how you do it. Because you go slow. Oh, oh! Raven!
Further, so he's probably qualified, yeah. Right?
Definitely qualified at this point. Oh! The hole! He's like a bouncer.
He's like the Asgard, right?
Asgard.
Yeah,
he's like the Asgardian. Is that what it is?
Yeah. That hole.
Alright, this dinosaur. Come on, man. No wonder dinosaur's got it. Go!
Come on. Oh! Okay, nice push. Come on, reset.
He's got it. He got assist, if anything. Right, the okay. Wizard. Yes. The horsey. Yeah.
There we go.
All right. Uh-huh. Oh, this is what I'm talking about, the slow jump. Oh, no, Raven! Oh, Hot Dog living dangerously. But he's going to just jump.
I think, like,
no, he's just, oh, okay.
Double
this
jump.
This is a good one. This is
now.
Good one. Oh, he's got to push it.
All right. 37, 38, 39.
Oh, he's got it. Oh, the ball.
Come on.
All right. He made it through. All right.
That was good. Go. Right. No mistakes. Go.
Simple.
Hey, buddy. Okay. No mistakes.
Slime?
Go. No mistakes.
Dino?
No mistakes. He dove in.
Other than salt, what are those things that you don't want in your food?
One. Just this drawbridge here.
Like a cactus casually moving by his own moon.
Oh, that was
double
dangerous.
Jump? Really
oh,
nice.
Man.
You got to take a risk.
Come on, baby. Come on.
Well, he's got plenty of ground to work with.
Nah, yeah, but this monkey, you can't trust monkeys. No! Here, this dinosaur, you know, starts picking up some eggs himself. Maybe he does a little bit of work. Look at this guy.
Well, he's picking himself up.
Look, he literally took a nap in his office.
The only thing he's picking up.
One. Or does he get your
double
first
jump,
one?
Double jump. All right.
Nice.
All right.
Oh. One. Yes. That's all.
Okay, let's just play safe. We got four more slots.
Oh!
Okay. Double jump.
Alright, that was good.
Okay.
Alright, let's go, Hot Dog.
Okay, we've got time.
Hot
Dog,
baby.
No one's qualified just yet.
Oh!
Alright.
That was a long range jump.
Come on, you can do it. You can do it.
Thank you so much to Team Fnatic for joining the AMD Streamer Challenge. We also want to remind you that this is your last chance to enter our giveaway. Let's just look for the gleam.io link in the chat to enter. You can win all sorts of great prizes, such as the headsets we've been using to cast AMD Streamer Challenge, the EPOS 600 series headsets featuring exceptional audio realism and performance, but we're going to be taking a quick break and we'll stay right tuned.
Welcome back, guys. For our final region, we have East Asia, which was powered by HP. Pikami from Japan and Acheon from Korea did battle on the HP Pavilion Gaming 15 laptops and EPOS 600 series headsets. Why did I do that? There's like a vibrate that I just... Oh, man, I should stop doing that. Anyways, they took on a series of special in-game Valorant challenges that tested their gaming skills and likely confused their opponents. They installed winning the most games or getting the most kills. Pikami and Acheon had to plant spikes, win spike rush games, and sometimes just survive while playing with fans. Wow, that is very complicated, but these guys were able to do it. So let's take a look at some of those highlights.
ピカピ敵が乗ったり、あそこにいるんですけれども、行くかピカミ、残り1面、タックルいった。倒した最後のスキルはピカミです。おめでとうございます。ね、あにゃすめね、안죽을수있습니다。よー。このちょ、おー。あー、オポスの게임재미없을까봐안썼다고했는데자이 정도면은
예!
すごいぞピカミ。おっとピカミまさかの2キルしたぞ。さあ来るのか。来るのか。来た。ナイスでございます。まさかのピカミナイス킬。あ、そのちょ、オンジャラバンで、お互いコンビか。いた、하면 잡았는데、2명이。2명이。하나 잡고。これで나요。1대1상황。남아있는거 룸에。でも、지금 어느 정도 뻔해요, 지금。おう。어,
살겠다 오니고 이러면 거의 확보하죠.
이거는 승리를
그렇죠.
아, 네 명을 자, 싸움 들었죠. 와, 놓치잖아요.
우세나 이거 아, 빨리 들. 오, 피카미. 피카미 마사카노 한도가 안 킬로 되고다이마스. 오, 또 그래. 아, 마사카. 오. 비키 나이스. 죽이고 좀 걸어가고 있거든요. 4대 2 상황. 안 맞아요.
아,
맞았어요.
맞았어요. 자.
13발.
오!
자, 피카빈 선수. 내라요 사담에 되어립니다. 피카빈 선수 다! 잡살 마키로 덮듯이 맞다.
이게 오히려 부스를 먹다가 와! 소리가 났으면
야, 이거 이거.
그 때문에 와!
소로천!
소로천!
네. 레이즈!
한 명.
아! 레이즈!
와!
자, 레이 하나 남았는데!
한 명!
아! 미쳤다!
오토!
아, 하야!
바토르! 와, 하야크라테서! 야바이, 피카미! 오토! 으시로 가라노 나이스키르! 오, 스몰 피카미! 잠깐만! 피카미! 잠깐만! 오 마이 갓! 피카미! 오 마이 갓! 피카미! 와우!
빠르고 있는 림파!
하나 잡았고
위로 올라가서!
오!
두아!
그렇죠!
역시! 궁극기가 있을 때 날아드는 기분입니다!
아브나이 아브나이! 스미마센네! 오또! 오또! 피카미! 코코리 키루 돋다! 스파이크 캐리아웃 나올 것도 같은데! 피카미! 코코 키루 돌로카! 코코리 키루 돌로카! 피카미! 코코리 피카미! 예쁘 겨! 피카미! 돈도 키루 돈! 쓰! 키루 돋다! 피카미!
쪽으로 우세를 가져가고 있고 오!
몰랐죠? 이거 사이포 선수만 빼고는 상대방은 살짝 초보의 느낌이 나는데 브리핑이 잘 안
됐거든요. 이야! 아! 소로천!
아까 스파차 とか そういうことはないからな そういうことはないですからね おー! まさかスパイ! まさか新しいスナイパーキルしている! 敵チームがどんどんどんどんオーブ取っていっているんじゃないかな 敵はみんなあそこにいる さあでも敵はみんな おーっと! まさかのナイスキル! ピカミ目の前でガッシャット! Right there! いったね!
さあ이게
おー! わー!
야, 방금 커브볼 빠르게 화면을 돌려서 피하면서 머리로 다시 나가는 에임.
와.
야.
자, 꽃쪽으로 바꾸고.
꽃쪽으로. 와.
그렇죠.
大丈夫か? 오토, 마지막의 1인이 됐습니다. 비! 메로마이 이사. 리다렉션. 알けれども. 右から 来るんじゃないか? 비가 요! 자, 나이스 콜. 오토.
자, 반대. 건너편도 봤죠?
네.
아, 대형 좋습니다, 지금.
아하. 자, 레인하기 때문에 바로 여기에서 아, 헤드. 좋죠. 아주 좋습니다.
반응 너무 좋았고. 와!
개코 피카미 선수 쪽으로 잡으러 나이스 킬 でございます. 마사카노 비크라 나이스 킬. 오또 바카스. 아브라이. 나이모 대장부. 오, 어, 후로 후로 때 후로 때. 어, 왔다. 피카미 나이스 킬 でございます. 우와, 미드나이 ところで 나이스 킬.
갔다.
おっと、視界を防いだ! さあ、パイクを設置したけど、 おっと、大丈夫か? おっと! ここでナイスでございます! あとはパイクを変え…
さあ、本じゃ남았는데 오, 그래도 하나
와우!
좋습니다
근데 세 명이나 하나… 오!
오! 인지하지 못했었죠?
오우!
긴 했는데
자, 한 명!
바트를 뽑지 않았고 위치는 계속 들키고 있어요
아, 이거를… 소로차!
이걸 해냈다고요?
어, those highlights were sick. Those are absolutely sick. Those are crazy highlights.
Yes, okay. I thought you were I thought you were going to go on.
Was waiting for the pause.
But yeah, that was just super good. Like we got a like super fun/highlights from Pikami and then we got like really insane fragging coming out from Acheon. That was insane.
I mean, it's just interesting seeing the like the energy levels, what's going on. One guy's very serious and kind of quiet and going on. You can hear the casters in the background, and the Pikami is just like in a world of her own, just bringing up that energy and everything. It's just very crazy in terms of the differences there. But this is going to be the end of the AMD Streamer Challenge. It's been great being able to cast alongside you, Asarai, for all of this. Any final words before we do close this one out?
AMD number one.
AMD number one. All right, so AMD number one. Okay, thank you again to all of the streamers, especially the fans for participating in the AMD Streamer Challenge. Without you guys, we would not have had any of this. So it's been great to see all of that, even the fan participating events that we had. All of that was great to see. And again, let me give a shout out to our sponsors, Acer, EPOS, HP, and Secretlab for making this event happen. My name is Haller, and with me was Asarai. Thank you so much, and we will see you guys next time. Thank you so much. Thank you.
We'll be right back.